Sportsman's Adventures is presented by Yamaha.
Hey, welcome to Sportsman's Adventures, and we're down here in the great Florida Keys off of Islamorada, a real famous place, a place called the Humps. This time of year, the month of June and July and August is one of Captain Randy's favorite times to fish for the blackfin tunas and also the Dorados. So you gotta stick with us to see what I got on here. Go, baby, that's what I'm talking about.
Only a mama could love that mouth.
What Florida is famous for.
As the sun rises on Islamorada in the Florida Keys, Captain Rick and his son Riz join Captain Randy Towe on the Contender 32ST and make their way to the Atlantic side of the island. Captain Randy knows these parts like the back of his hand. He also knows that where we are going is pretty rough, even on a calm day, but the potential rewards are worth it.
Randy, where are we?
This is one of the many humps offshore. It's actually Hawks K, right out in front of Hawks K Humps, the 409 we call it.
Uh-huh.
Pretty popular spot. A lot of things live here. You know, you got surface fish, you got bottom fish, you've got other white marlin, blue marlin, mako sharks. This used to be one of the great mako shark spots in the spring.
All right, Ridgey's cranking him up right now.
Let's crank him up before he gets bit.
Not too much pulling, but hey. He's gonna be here shortly.
I sees him.
Hey, be careful you use that word shortly around yourself, bub.
Little tuna.
That's what we're here for.
Hey!
Ceviche.
Right there.
There you go. Look out. Ah!
Mr. Blackfin tuna.
That's a perfect size if we were marlin fishing for bait, wouldn't it be, bub?
Well, you know, it ain't a bad size for a sandwich.
And look, Ridge, when you turn him over and you look straight down on him, look at how his fins, that's how he gets the name black fin. Certainly a yellowfin has yellow fins here, but that's how you can always see it. And the football shape, for sure. As they get bigger, they really get the football shape. Right, Randy?
Look how he's got his dorsal fins stick out like that. I mean, He goes through the water at high speed all the time.
Yeah.
He's going like he's out of cigarettes all the time.
So we gonna keep that one, or we gonna let him go?
What do you want to do? Take the hook out. It's up to you.
I like eating tunas. Is there any size limit to the tunas?
You know, there's not, but we might catch some bigger ones. A couple of these aren't bad to eat either. I mean, they're a good size.
Let's eat that one then.
Okay. If you watch the birds, like right now, you can see the birds are on the deck. They're on the surface. And the whole key to the birds, the reason they're doing what they're doing is because the fish are pushing the bait to the surface. So when the bait gets to the surface from the fish, whether it's dolphin or tunas, these birds come down to the water. That's when you want to get lined up on those crosshairs and get near those birds because the fish are up high. Once the birds come back up a little higher, fish go down, bait goes down, everything kind of settles down, so there's no surface activity.
So the birds use the height, like we would a tower, as elevation to look down in the water and see the fish as they're starting to push the bait up.
Exactly. Cool. And as those fish run through, like here, when those tunas, there's a lot of them, so they push that bait and a ball comes up to the surface. You know, anytime you can look around us and you see 50 at a time flying fish coming out of the water. Same kind of thing. When those baits come out of the water like that, birds are going to get on them as quick as they can to catch them.
Right.
Because they're flying, easy prey. When they're out of the water, they get them.
Yeah. Okay,
that's
man.
That's how that works.
Well.
Let's do it again.
I sees them over there.
All right, here we go.
Nice.
All right. Well, you know what?
Whoa, good catch.
Still going to eat.
A little pink worm. So what's the significance of the worm there, Randy? What do you think that is?
You know what? It's got to look like a flying fish or something in the water. Now, granted, I've never seen a pink flying fish, but it's got to be something to it because they like that bright color.
Yeah.
Especially early in the morning.
Why don't you show me how to vent his radiator? So you hold them upside down. Just stick your finger in there.
Right underneath there. Just push down.
Yeah.
And then come up.
That's it.
That's it.
And so by bleeding them, that's gonna make the meat a lot better.
What it does is it gets all the blood out of the meat. You know, sometimes you fillet a fish and it's got that, you know, blood in the meat and you kind of soak it and you try to get it out. Well, when you've got tunas like this and you can bleed them, he'll bleed all that blood out and you just got nice pink meat when you go to cut it.
Now, can you do the same thing if the tuna was much bigger?
Absolutely. You know, if he was... Oh yeah, yellow fins, blue fins, any of them.
I want to learn that trick because when we went with RT, you know, we were down there behind the shrimp boats, we would take the knife and he would stick them, I think, somewhere in here, and then that would bleed them too. But
yeah, they have a little, it's just a little artery right there.
Right there.
See where my finger is?
Uh-huh.
It's right on top. So if you stick your finger in like that and just come up.
And break it.
And break it. That's all you got to do. You know, no knife and digging around.
Right.
And now he's pumped it all out.
Yeah.
So this is going to be a really nice piece of meat when we go to clean it. Nice and pink.
I brought my Williamson knife, so I can't wait to see that.
All right, well, I'm going to show it to you in a little while.
Okay.
Sportsman's Adventures is brought to you by Yamaha. Reliability starts here. Rapala. Catch the latest at rapala.com. Costa Sunglasses. See what's out there. Okuma. There's no stopping Okuma. VMC, your expert in hooks. Williamson Lures, for the pelagic playground. Ameritrail, building trailers for over 30 years. And Startron, cures and prevents ethanol fuel problems. At Yamaha, reliability is a family tradition. Meet the next generation. Four new advanced technology-inspired inline four-cylinder performers. Bred from the reliability and boater satisfaction that is part of Yamaha's DNA. They prove that when power gets lighter, faster, stronger, and smarter, boating gets even better and more satisfying for boaters like you.
Remember the glory days of gasoline? It's just not made the same anymore.
Kick your gas into gear with Startron. Pump up the performance in all of your engines. Cure the problems of ethanol with the power of enzymes. And maximize your mileage every time you drive. Kickstart your engines with Startron.
We've made our name helping anglers unlock the water's hidden secrets. Hit the switch. It's time to reveal even more. AutoChart Live gives you the power to build your own high-definition maps anywhere in the world in real time. Because when you know the unknown, you can do the unheard of. AutoChart Live. Only from Humminbird.
It's one of the most ancient forms of hide and seek known to man. And nobody knows how to play the fishing game better than the backcountry guides and offshore captains of the Florida Keys and Key West. Ready or not, here we come.
Thanks for watching Sportsman's Adventures. You can catch all the latest happenings, contests, and appearances by liking us on Facebook and following us on Twitter and Instagram. You never have to miss a show. And you can also find episodes of Sportsman's Adventures plus other techniques and tips on our YouTube channel. Also, if there's a product that we use during the show and you'd like to know more information on, you can find links to our sponsors by heading over to sportsmansadventures.com. So Randy, since the FWC put a size limit on the dolphins, You think that's really helped and improved the dolphin's size and fishery?
You know, I'm not so sure, because there's still so many times we catch dolphin this size and smaller.
Right.
You know, I think it's a...
But the fish has to be, what's the limit?
20 inches.
20 inches, and that's from the nose to the fork?
It's, yes.
Okay.
And I think the beauty of this, if you didn't have some limit on them, a length, people would take all the sizes.
Right.
And, you know, letting these fish grow, they grow so fast. This fish, by the time it gets off North Carolina in a couple of months, will be a 10 or 12 pounder.
And that's the whole concept. Now, maybe it's not just helping the Florida's fishery, you know, but it's certainly, look at him changing colors as we speak.
Oh, yeah. But you, it's look at the big picture.
Helping the fishery in general.
These things are all over the world, you catch mahis. I mean, it's really amazing, that fishery, that species, how dominant they are all over the world. Everybody's got them.
Right.
And some places, they don't have little ones.
Right.
All theirs are big.
Right.
You know, here, I think we're really like a nursery for a lot of these big schools of dolphin coming through the straits and going to the Bahamas and up the coast, out of the Gulf. And that's why you'll find some days you'll catch all you want of small fish that don't even make the, you know, the legal length.
Right.
But they're still fun. Guys will come out here with a fly rod, catch them on fly rod or light tackle.
Yeah. Well, that's good. So the whole idea is to let them grow up and get at least big enough to spawn maybe one time to put more babies in the system.
Exactly. You know, they get over that 20 inch, they get 24, 30 inches, they probably start reproducing.
Right.
They do it pretty young.
All right. I'm ready to
try it
reproduce
again.
Another one of those, so let's do that.
Put them out.
Now, Randy, we got one on here, we got one on there. Now you got one almost tried to eat you there. So what's the idea? Why does everybody always want to leave one in the water?
Well, if you leave one in the water, they'll stay together. And what we're trying to do here is just be patient and see if there's a bigger fish. A lot of times a 30 or 40 pounder will swim up because he's curious. Hey, yeah. What's going on?
Right. You know, the other thing that you need to remember too, guys, is when you always want to try to pay attention to the number of when you hook the fish. Randy hooked his first, Ridge hooked one, his jumped off, Randy hooked another one, then mine was the last fish hooked. So we'd want to leave mine in the longest. And the reason why is because every time these fish come up and jump, they regurgitate. When they regurgitate, here's a bigger fish.
Yep, I see.
The bigger fish right there. Throw it, Ridge. Every time they regurgitate, and it's like having a living chum ball for
you. Your own chum slip.
Yep. Got him, Randy?
Yep.
Oh, that's a little better fish. Yeah, that's a little better fish.
There you go.
That's all right, go ahead.
Now here,
ahead,
I wanted,
it,
I wanted a little ballyhoo.
Oh, I'm gonna go ahead and get this one out of the water, Randy.
Okay.
Is that all right?
Yeah, yeah.
We keeping this small one, or is he too small, right?
Yeah, you could let him go.
Huh?
You could let him go. Okay. I'm just trying. There might be a bigger one here.
Okay.
See if they want to eat the ballyhoo.
Here.
Just leave him out there.
A nice fish, Ridge. Get him in there, boy! Hey! That's the little bull. That's the little bull there, Randy.
Oh, yeah? Nice.
Look how pretty he is. I just love the different colors. Now, you see, he jumped. There he flung that out there. We have to watch to see if that gets eaten. Hey, 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 cut the crap. There goes some more. Come on, stop it. Stop it.
You can keep that one. There's some sandwiches there.
Just keep this one?
Yeah. A little bigger than the last one.
Getting the hook back on this one. Love it. Look at all the little beautiful, little clear fins, blue dots, little mouth. Only a mama could love that mouth. Take him home, put him in the house. Go with a couple little tunas. Got fried dolphin and sushi. Sushi tuna. What else you got for me, boys?
Sportsman's Adventures is brought to you by PowerPole, Swift, Silent, Secure. Contender Boats, performance through innovation. FWC, the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission. Cletus Cubs, tie one on. Maverick Boat Group, makers of premium boat brands Maverick, Hughes, and Pathfinder. The American Fishing Tackle Company, precision tackle and performance clothing since 1958. The Florida Keys and Key West, come as you are. Suffix, the world's most hardcore fishing line. And Humminbird, simply, clearly, better.
You know there's more to it than luck. There's fishing the right bait, the water temperature, the wind, the season, and then there's the boat. We'll put it simply, the boat matters. To own a Contender is to own the best sport fishing boat on the market, period. Contender offers the most comprehensive model range with bigger, faster, and more fuel-efficient boats than the competition. There's only one choice for serious anglers. Contender Boats. Performance through innovation.
Shadow Wrap Shad's a jerkbait with a secret move. When you pause, the lure slowly rises. I tell you, man, it makes fish come unglued.
At Yamaha, reliability is a family tradition. Meet the next generation. Four new advanced technology-inspired inline four-cylinder performers. Bred from the reliability and boater satisfaction that is part of Yamaha's DNA. They prove that when power gets lighter, faster, stronger, and smarter, boating gets even better. And more satisfying for boaters like you.
As close as you're gonna get to a sure thing for catching billfish is Casa Vieja Lodge.
They're here, man. This has been a 20-year run, buddy. These things haven't left, there's no cycle.
When it comes to sailfishing, this is the real deal.
The amount of sailfish here is ridiculous.
Today's Coast to Cool Place and Moment is about the 100th anniversary of the National Park System. Now certainly this is a very important deal to the Florida Keys because it borders three national parks that we know of, Biscayne National Park, Everglades National Park, and the Dry Tortugas west of Key West. Woodrow Wilson created the park system on August 25th, 1916. There was 35 parks then, and there's 59 parks today. Yellowstone is the first national park to ever be put into park system, and it was signed in 1872, but there just wasn't a park system at that time. There's 27 states in the United States that have parks, and Wrangell St. Elias, which is 8 million acres in Alaska, is the largest. Arkansas has the smallest park, which is Hot Springs with only 6,000 acres. There's a total of 51.9 million acres of parks here in the U.S., and that's why the park system's 100th anniversary is today's Costa Cool Place and Moment. Bring it to me, Randy.
I'm coming.
I want to see if they'll eat a little skitter walk, take some inshore technology to the offshore dance.
To the dark side.
Look at that, using a redfish rod and a snook lure.
That's like a...
Oh!
Going hunting for an elephant with right a BB there. Gun.
The second it hit the water, he ate.
Oh, hey.
Oh. Watch out. Wing it, man. Careful. Be careful. Stand back. I don't know how bad this treble hook's going to be.
Look at that fly. Jumper.
Look. Oh! Look.
There you go.
Dang, look at that dolphin. Looks like he's got a slug lure in his face, because he does. I like it on this light little rod.
Oh, that's a perfect rod for these dolphins.
A little video Helios 40. Suffix 10 pounds. Oh, he's jumping there. Love it.
I have to join you with this pluck action.
Golly, that was so cool when he dropped popping on the surface. Get a ridge. Look at them all trying to eat ridges. There we go. We should take the hooks off and just throw it out there.
This on that Williamson bait.
Williamson?
It's only got two J hooks in it. Or is that Storm bait?
Oh no, the Williamson, the big Williamson topwater.
The big Williamson topwater.
Oh, cool. Got the single hooks on that one, huh, Rich?
Yeah, but I guess we still didn't think this one through, huh?
Speak for yourself, boy.
There we go. You should be quiet for a little bit. Let me get this out of you.
There we go. I got this one out. Look, he ain't just skitter walk. Look, don't do that again, okay? I love
Look
it.
Look at him.
And watch how fast they're going to listen to you. You said you wanted to catch dolphins?
Yeah, man.
Well, here we are.
Okay.
Gotta love it.
That's what I like about you, Mr. Towe. Put in my order, and next thing you know, it's delivered. Oh! I got him on there, Randy. The peanut.
Peanut?
Nice. I tell you what, I like it on these lighter rods. It makes it fun.
Oh, it is
just
fun.
Downsize the tackle, and it makes it really fun. Oh, you got you, Rich. He was after you.
Saw that. I'm trying to get in there and join it.
There you go. Oh, just keep twitching. Told ya. That's what I mean. Just keep twitching. Not sure what to do, twitch again.
Woo! You know about twitching.
I do. Did you see that? Flying fish jumped out of the water and ran into Ridge's line. They went catapulting.
Flying fish is probably going, get me out of here. Come on.
Hey, Randy, I think you just got eaten.
Oh, that's a bigger one right here. That's a real one there, Rick.
Don't wear that treble hook in my hand. Oh, there he is again.
It's a single hook, no trebles.
That's a better
not on this
right
X-Rap.
Good.
It's a dolphin rodeo.
It is a dolphin rodeo. Oh, yeah.
Catch them on plugs,
Mr. Bale, I appreciate you bringing me in my son Ridge out here. I can't tell you how many fish we've already caught this morning, and it's not even 8:30. The early bird get the worm. We'll be back eating lunch.
Most people still sleeping.
At the Lorelei.
It's all about making memories.
Yeah, man.
There we go. Oh, there he is.
Nice. Is that the Williamson Ridge?
Yep.
Surface Pro 130.
Surface Pro 130.
Olive and gold. Looks just like a little goggle eye.
You know, we've got some nice cows on right now, and the bull is probably still out there with all these fish. We haven't hooked him up yet. So we're trying to get all these other fish on in hopes that we can weed through and find the big one.
Nice fish. Good job, Randy.
Don't matter what it takes, just get him in the boat with that guy.
There's a leader.
I know, bub, but you gotta back up.
Stick him.
Hey! There you go, Ridge!
That's what I'm talking about right there!
That's what we come to the Florida Keys for, right there, buddy! Randy's out!
Get that gaff away.
Who's your daddy?
What? You are! You're the big fish man!
Nice job!
Good job, Ridge! Put him in there. Good job, man. Hey! Good job, Ridge. That's probably the biggest dolphin you ever caught, isn't it?
One of them. It's been a while since I caught one like that.
Mr. Towe.
Hey, fish fans. That's how you get it done.
That is how you get it done.
Good job.
Hey, if you ever want to come down to the Florida Keys, catch a lot of fish, and even maybe a big one once in a while, make sure you come down and fish with Randy, because you'll understand why he makes it always a great sportsman's adventure.
Keep up with the latest Sportsman's Adventures news and events by logging into our website at sportsmansadventures.com and following us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Coming up next week on Sportsman's Adventures with Captain Rick Murphy. We take a trip to the world-famous Tropic Star Lodge in Panama. But what makes this adventure even more memorable is we are fishing with none other than Guy Harvey.